In this video, we're going to show you how to plan a full moon alignment with the Statue of Liberty. First, let's open up Planit. Next, we're going to search for the Statue of Liberty. There it is right there, so we'll click on it. As you can see, it's on a small island called Liberty Island. Now, if you zoom out on the map and look at the surroundings, you'll see why this statue is a relatively good subject to shoot with the moon alignment. And that's because you can see here, and over here, and even over here, these are all open spaces where you have a lot of potential for different camera locations to choose from. So in this demo, we're going to use the moonrise of September the 10th, 2022 as an example to show you how to find different camera locations. First step is to tap the marker for the Statue of Liberty like that. Set that as the scene location. Just that, there we go. Second step is to swipe down from the title bar to see the ephemeris page chooser. And we're going to choose the light and shadow page, as you can see there. And here's the shadow caused by the sunlight. Well, let's explain a little bit why we use the shadow to pick the camera location. So if you think about it and you're standing at the tip of the shadow and you step back a few feet, you'll see the sun. But if you move forward a few feet, the sun will be gone because it's blocked by the Statue of Liberty. Is that location a good one for the sun alignment? Absolutely. And it works exactly the same way for the shadow from the moon, or the shadow that's caused by the moonlight. Now we can drag the slider like this to a different time of day, and you can see how the shadow moves along with it. And here you can see that the sun icon means that the shadow that you see here is the sun shadow. And since we're looking for is the moon shadow, no problem. Just drag the shadow slider until you can see the moon. And now we have this shadow over here is the shadow from the moonlight. Let's go ahead and zoom out. And we can move the slider so that the tip of the shadow is somewhere over here. And to do that, we're going to adjust to the minute slider so we can really fine tune the time. And make sure if you drag the slider very slowly, you can see the tip of the shadow is exactly at the location you want it to be. Long press there, set this location as the camera location like this. And we have the plan to take the picture from there. So we're going to tap on the viewfinder button and switch to the VR viewfinder like this. Boom, there we go. There's the Statue of Liberty and you can see the moon. It's really small, but that's fine. We'll just change the focal length to, 400 millimeters. And we can change the viewfinder so that we can look at the scene, which is the top of the Statue of Liberty. Oh, look at this. Here it is. We've got the moon. We've got the torch. Statue of Liberty is right just there. It's almost perfect. Now, it looks like the moon is a little lower than we expected it to be. So we're going to adjust the time first, like this, to get the moon vertically at the location we want it to be, right by this red line. And then we can move our camera to the left or the right. Now, sometimes this is a little confusing about which direction should we move when you have this situation. Well, the trick is straightforward. If you want the moon to move to the left, then you move to the left. Conversely, if you want the moon to move to the right, then you need to move to the right. So it's basically the same direction as the camera movement as the moon. So in this case, we want the moon to move to the left, so we're going to move to the left. Like this, we're going to click on this little thing, this little button right here. And this is a shortcut that'll move the camera by 1 meter. And over here on the right, that'll move the camera to the right by 1 meter. If you press and hold it, on the other hand, it'll move by 10 meters. But in this case, that's a little much. So we just want it to move a small distance, fine movement in our case. So we'll click on it once. Here it is. And you can see the moon is pretty much where we want it to be. So we're going to go back to the map, find out where the camera location is. That looks good. Somewhere right around here, and we've got a good location, so we're going to save that as a task, and we can load that back up later if we want. Now, this is a very popular spot for the Statue of Liberty, so if you go there that night, you will probably be welcomed by many photographer friends, and it might get a little bit crowded. So do we want to find a different location that's perhaps not so crowded? Absolutely. So let's go zoom out so we can go further away from the statue. And we might find another location that'll work just fine. So again, we're going to adjust the time slider like this so we can see the shadow moving. Here it is. You can see it right there, and it's going to touch the shore right just there. So we go to that spot, zoom in there. Look at this. There's exactly where we're going to be. Oh, I love this. So we tap there, put the camera location there, and have another look at the viewfinder. Oh, that looks good. And in fact, in this case, if you compare this version with the previous one, you can see that the moon is relatively larger because we're further away from the statue. And this location probably has much fewer people than the Black Tom Island location. So we're going to save this one as a task. and we should be good to go. And if you don't want to scout either of these locations, either this one or that one, you can also look over for different locations, additional locations as different possibilities. There might be some ones over here, but you probably want to scout those ahead of time to be sure. Now, this app, Planit Pro, can do much more than what we show in this video. So stay tuned for more video tutorials. Thanks so much and have a great day.